honor, and if he dies, he's a shaheed. Mm. You know, you have to defend yourself. You have to defend your rights.
Especially in the case of insurance, people sue and it's like putting out wrong information, like they have no Nexor for like 6 months. They don't have really the
next one. The insurance, Bashman Sharif. Insurance, subhanAllah, there are too many ways people are playing in it. Yani you have to ask your heart first for the insurance, especially. Because people make millions of dollars because of this insurance. Doctors and the people, and they lie, they make a lot of stories. Yeah. Yes. If you don't have fear of Allah, this is a big problem, you know. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله, we just finished Ramadan. And we've been talking a lot in the month of Ramadan, but as we said before, the end of Ramadan is the beginning of the Abad. Really, wallahi. I consider Ramadan just a training, and we finished the 30 days, and now we are starting our Ibadat now. This is the start after Ramadan. So that's why sometimes I'm telling myself, give myself 1 week, 2 weeks, why I have to give lecture every day? You know, I've been talking for 30 days. Take it, man, take it easy. And my mind is telling me why. Take it easy until you die, inshallah. يعني work Allah, work and worship Allah until you die, not in the end of Ramadan. وعبد ربك حتى تك اليقين. When I die, inshallah, I will take it easy there. That's it. سبحان الله. يعني I see my wife very sad yesterday and today. I ask her there now before I come. Why sad? And I saw you on your Facebook page. You're putting the na'i for some condolence for somebody died. But in our family, she said, no. One of my students, Egyptian, 27 years in New York, she died, and I never saw her. But she's my lecturer, she's giving lecture, mashallah, every week, like 40,000 people around the world. And she died, and she's to ask me too many questions, and I never saw her, but she just figured out, last day of Ramadan, she died. 27 years, young girl. Yeah, New York, subhanAllah. Life is very short, and the wa'abud rabbak hatta yatiyak al-yaqeen. Today, let's talk about this Salah. Sheikh was reciting from Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah Al-Istijaba, last 2 pages or 3 pages, you know. And he finished the page before last page. Yeah, it was about to say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقْتْ لَهُمْ مِنَ الْحُسْنَ أُولَئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبْعَدُونَ. The end of the Surah, Surah Al-Anbiya, the chapter of the prophets. And see how these prophets, may Allah be pleased with them, they turn their face to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Whenever they need anything, they used to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla. Sayyidina Ayyub, Sayyidina Zakariya, all of these Anbiya, Allah mentioned Maryam, and Subhanallah, Sayyidina Yunus, and all of these Anbiya, Subhanallah, they used to turn their face to Allah whenever they used to need anything. And Subhanallah, there is a certain Salah for us as Muslims. We've been asked to do this Salah, but people are neglecting this Salah. Who did this Salah? Who make it? Prophet Ibrahim? When that king in Egypt was about to attack to raid Sarah, his wife, and he told her, don't tell him I'm your husband because they're gonna kill me. Tell him I am your brother. Yes. And he tried to touch her too many times. Sayyidina Ibrahim started praying to Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Rabbi, save my wife. And Allah answered. The same Salah, Sayyidina Zakariya, when he saw Maryam with the fruits, from where you get this? I am the one who's taking care of you. I am the one who has the key of your mihrab. Nobody allowed to enter except me, Prophet Zakariya. وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابِ وَجَدَ عِنْدَهَا رِزْقًا قَالَ يَا مَرْيَمُ أَنَّ لَكِ هَذَا قَالَتْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ
From
different season. Some scholars they said from different season, and some scholars said from different fruits, the area or wherever they live in the same area, they never saw these fruits before. From where you get this? But the scholar said from different season, winter and summer, summer and winter. طيب, this is not the point too. I have the key. Who gave it to you? Nobody allowed to enter, just me. And she said, هو من عند الله. فسيدنا زكريا went to المحراب and started his prayer. He did this salah too. The same salah, who make it جريج العابد, the monk جريج. Jurayj was Abid. I love his story so much. He was a monk, that man. His mom used to say, Jurayj, I miss you, my son. He used to cut himself from the dunya, sitting in his sawma temple or synagogue, wherever he used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out from the dunya. And his mom, I miss you, I want to see you. And he was praying. He said, Ya Rab, my salah or my mom? Forget about her, my salah. And he's saying his prayer. Second day, Ya Juraj, my son, I miss you. I miss you. Let me see you. He was praying all the time. Monk, Abid. He said, Ya Rab, my salah or my mom? My salah or my mom? My salah. Forget about her. Third day also is coming. Ya Juraj, Juraj. He's lacking everything. And subhanAllah, my salah or my mom? Ya Rab. Say, my salah. Forget about her. And the lady, she get mad. And she said, Allahumma la tumithu hatta yara wujuh al-mumisat. Of course, this is a good message for every mother. Don't make dua against your son, even if he makes you mad. Look what happened to him. Oh Allah, don't let him die. She made dua against him. She prayed against him. Until he sees the faces of the prostitute women, or those who are working prostitution. Subhanallah. You know, the enemy of al-anbiya, the enemy of those who are salihin, they are everywhere until the day of judgment. Allah said in the Quran, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ هَدِيًا وَنَصِيرًا. صح؟ سورة الفرقان؟ صح؟ Allah appointed for each and every Nabi enemy, عدو, from the criminals until the day of judgment. الصالحين, the sheikhs, the anbiya, it's the way, the way. And they used to, subhanAllah, they said, what can we do with this Juraj? He think he's better than us. And they try to send women to him, to seduce him, and he never. And finally, they found that woman, she was a prostitute woman, Ghani. She made zina with a shepherd in the desert, adultery, and she became pregnant. They asked her.
To blame it.
Exactly. Who did this? She said, Juraj. Juraj? Yeah, they get him from his sawa. And they torture him in the way, in the way. And while he was working in the chain and they beat him up all the way, they took him to the judge or whatever. They've been beating him up in the street. And the prostitute women, they were standing in the side of the way. And they looked at him and they start laughing. And they said, Gaban, you're laughing to the women. And he said, no, I'm laughing because my mom make dua against me. Subhanallah. Yes, yeah, my mom is da'wah. Allah accepted from her, subhanallah. And he was looking at the faces of the mumisat, the prostitute woman, and he started laughing at him. Not laughing because he want to look at them, because his mom's dua against him. Yeah, subhanallah. Mom, what happened? They said, now we're going to put you on the cross and we're going to kill you right now. He said, before you kill me, before you do anything, let me pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This prayer I'm talking about. And he started praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This prayer, when you are in need, you are in difficulty, you are in hardship, you, subhanallah, ala tu, just go. Arihna biha ya bilal. Rasulullah s.a.w. kana idha hazabahu amr. During his difficulty and hardship, Bilal called for the prayer. Allahu Akbar, and he should be certain. But this prayer, people are neglecting this prayer nowadays. Juraj, when he finished his prayer, he said, give me the baby. After she delivered the baby, give me the baby. Before they kill him, they were about to kill him. And he poked the baby in his, infant baby in his stomach. Like this, he poked him with his finger. Who's your dad? Who's your finger? Who's your father? Like this to the baby. And the baby was saying, my father, the Ra'i, the shepherd, so and so. Allah allowed him to talk in the cradle while he was in the cradle. For him, Allah answered this dua. Oh, you are, subhanAllah. What happened after they destroyed his temple or Sawma? They said, Juraj, you are the best of us. There's some miracle. And we ask, we're going to build it up for you from gold. We're going to make it instead of clay, gold. He said, no. Just return it back as is, and they're going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, the main point of what I'm saying is salah. What kind of salah is this? In Islam, they call it Salatul Haja. Salatul Al Haja. Whenever you are in need, hardship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make to wudu and just pray to rak'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tell him everything what you are making sujood. That's it. But be sincere when you pray. Whatever you need, they call it Salatul Haja. That's Salah, a special prayer for any kind of needs. We are all in need to Allah azza wa jalla, right?
Of course.
Yes. Ya ayyuhan nas, antumul. إلى الله والله هو الغني الحميد سبحانه وتعالى he's independent self sufficient but we are in need to him. الله الصمد الذي يصمد إليه الخلائق للقضاء حوائجه الذي everybody in need to him and he's سبحانه وتعالى free from all kind of needs. For this salah, it's a message. If you need anything, just make salah. Arihna biha ya Bilal. Let us go to salah ya Bilal. Yeah, if you need anything, just go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask him. And who did that? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the time. When he was coming from Taif, they stoned him. Blood is coming out from his body. 50 kilometers from Taif, the Jamrat al-Aqaba al-Ula, where we stone Iblis, walking in this desert, and the blood is out from his body. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that dua. He said, Allahumma, oh Allah. Allahumma inni ashku ilayka da'fa quwwati wa qillat haylati wa hawani ala nas. Allahumma in lam yakun bika ghadabun alayya falawbali. And he started complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Jibril came with the angel of the mountains. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them with the Al-Akhshabain, Allah will do it. That's it. We'll finish them in a second. He said, no, I'm not coming to destroy people, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. I'm coming to guide them. Yes, I'm coming for their rahmah. And Allahumma ahdi qawmi fi innahum la ya'lamun. Oh Allah, guide my people because they know not. Yes, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's very important to focus about this salah if you need anything. And that will connect you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like what we said all the time. The salah in general, second, the dua. Dua will connect you with Allah and salat al-hajah to salah, to rak'ahs, to units. And just when you finish it, raise your hand. Or in your sujood, أقرب ما يكون العبد إلى ربه هو ساجد. The near is the closest to Allah while you are making sujood. Ask Allah. Talk to him. InshaAllah. جزاكم الله خير. Any time, but the best time, the last third of every night. This is my favorite. يعني صراحة. Because last third of every night, Allah is coming to our heaven. It's descending. And it's not just descending. No. Allah is offering you. هل من سائل? Anybody asking? هل من تائب? Anybody making توبة? هل من مستغفر? Huh? Allah, the one he's offering you. فأنت خلاص. يعني just during that time, just send it. That's it. Yeah. I'm asking Allah عز وجل to يعني, fulfill our wishes and to save all of us, يا رب العالمين, in this dunya and the akhirah from any kind of harm and hurt. I mean, يا رحمة ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا واسترنا واجبرنا. نسألك يا ربنا من خير ما سألك منه عابدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من كل شر استعاذ منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا ربنا اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. إنك يا رب سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. جزاكم الله خيرا.